we've got gusty winds, cloudy conditions, and now we've got some rainfall from Nicole beginning to enter into the area here just right around noon. We've got a flood watch in effect for the mountains starting tonight through tomorrow night. We've got a lot of rain coming down in a short amount of time, so a lot of that's going to kind of carry over into area streams and along area roads as well. There will be ponding on area roads everywhere, but that flood watch is in effect for the mountains primarily. We've also got a wind advisory for the entire viewing area. This also kicks into effect tonight through tomorrow night. Wind gusts upwards of 35, even 40, possibly 45 miles per hour as the core or the center of the remnants of Nicole begin to get a little bit closer to us. Here's a look at tonight. You can see those winds still up all the way through 10, 11 o'clock, 25, 30 miles an hour. We continue with these blustery conditions throughout the day tomorrow as well. 20, 30, again, possibly 40 mile an hour wind gusts. These are not sustained winds, but these are some of those stronger wind gusts that can kind of blow those leaves around, clog the drains, blow some of those decorations around if you have some of those out. So just keep that in mind. As we take a look, Tropical Storm Nicole still projected to move basically just to the west or right over Greenville and much of the upstate. Our risk for severe weather is in the moderate category as you take a look out to the coast. If you have friends or loved ones in Myrtle Beach, Charleston, down into Savannah, we've got a risk of some possible severe thunderstorms with some very high winds, and even an isolated tornado or two cannot be ruled out. As we go into tomorrow, the risk for isolated tornadoes along the coast is still there, but you can see we begin to get a low-level risk as we move a little bit closer to home, just to the east of Greenville. The same risk. We're looking at the possibility of some strong winds embedded in some of these severe thunderstorms, and again, some low-level rotation, but again, that risk for us right now is low. Some of these outer bands beginning to move in. You notice the center of Nicole moving back out into the Gulf of Mexico. Some of these outer bands or feeder bands are beginning to head our way. So the upstate picking up on a little bit of rain right now. This will increase as we head into tonight and certainly during the overnight hours. Here's a look at tomorrow morning. We're going to be looking at some rainfall for your morning commute, and then heading into mid-morning all the way through tomorrow afternoon. This is going to be the heaviest rain. This is 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, we are looking at a lot of rainfall. That's going to be that time frame where the heaviest rain will be about 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And then we slowly begin to see this kind of taper off. So as we go into tomorrow night, we will dry out and those winds will calm down. And we are looking at just a lot of rain for most of us, at least a good soaking rain. Anywhere from 1 to 3 inches of rainfall. Some locations could get 3 or 4 as you travel up along the mountains, say right along I-40. Or just north and east of there. Then as we go into the very next day, Saturday, we've got a cold front that's going to come through, and this cold front is going to pull down cooler, drier air from Canada, and we are going to return to not just cold air, but freezing temperatures for the upstate and the mountains starting Sunday morning. So we've got a lot of changes on the way. Mid-60s today. We're going to warm up tomorrow, Veterans Day, with those hit and miss heavy amounts of rain coming and going throughout the day. But again, it'll be done by tomorrow night. Cold front comes through Saturday. Saturday will kick up a few extra clouds and maybe an isolated shower in the mountains as that frontal system pushes through. But otherwise, it's all about that much colder air that starts on Sunday.